Learn what Azure DevOps projects are and how to use them with Node.js and Kubernetes in this episode of Azure Tips and Tricks. Azure DevOps Project is a wizard-like experience that makes it easy for you to create builds and deployments in Azure DevOps, which is Microsoft's application lifecycle management suite. Let's create a new DevOps project. Here I search for DevOps, and it comes up with DevOps Project. Let's click on it. And now I'll create it, which takes me to the wizard experience. This is the easiest way to start with Azure DevOps. First, I'll pick Node.js. This creates a new Node application for me. And next, I must pick an application framework for my Node app. I'll leave it to Express.js. This is a very simple framework to work with. All right, next. Now I must pick how I want to deploy the application. I'll choose Kubernetes. This will deploy the application in containers and uses the Azure Kubernetes service to do the container orchestration for me. Okay. Now for the final part. I need to fill in a name for the Azure DevOps project here and pick a subscription. This DevOps project is going to use the Azure T&T Azure DevOps organization. This is basically the Azure DevOps subscription that you need to do builds and releases with. What else? Let's look at the advanced settings to make sure that everything is set okay. This all looks all right. But this doesn't. This DevOps project will create and use an Azure container registry to store container images, and the name for it is already in use. This happens sometimes, as the container registry name needs to be unique, and it takes the DevOps project name that I just filled in, so my app, and adds ACR for Azure Container Registry to it. Let's fix that. Okay, there we go. And that's it. Let's create it. After I press done, the Azure DevOps project will be created, along with all of the resources, like a Kubernetes cluster. It will also build and deploy the Node application for us. All of this takes a while, so I'll skip ahead to when this is done. And here we go. This is the Azure DevOps project, and it has built the Node application and deployed it. There is lots to see here. Here we have the build and release pipelines. Here are the Azure resources that are created. And here is the source code repository that contains all of the code for the application. And here is a link to Application Insights, which is monitoring the application. Let's take a look at the source code. This takes us to the Azure DevOps portal. If you have never seen this, you're in for a treat. You can use this portal to host code, create builds and releases, manage package feeds, test your application, and more. So this is the repository that contains the application code and also the Azure Resource Manager templates that help to deploy the Azure resources for the application. This code was cloned from the DevOps project samples GitHub project, to which you can find a URL in the description of this video. Let's go back to the DevOps project and let's look at the build that compiled the application code. This also takes us to the Azure DevOps portal. As you can see by now, the Azure DevOps project is just a simple front-end that helps you to create things in Azure DevOps. This is the build that created the artifacts for the application. Let's edit it. Now we can see all of the steps that the build process goes through to compile the code and create the package that will be released. You can see that it first creates the Azure Container Registry and builds a Docker container image. Next, it pushes that Docker image to the Azure Container Registry. From there, it can be used by Helm to create a package that can run in Azure Kubernetes service. Helm is a technology that is used to deploy applications to Kubernetes. Let's move back to the code repository. Here you can see the charts/sample apps directory, which contains the packages that Helm created that will deploy the application to Kubernetes. As you can see, the Azure DevOps project has done so much for us. In the next video, we'll explore the rest of the resources that it created for us.